Hello guys and welcome back to another video. Today we are going to talk about chapter 8 in morphology, morpheme, and introductory to English grammar. So now chapter 8 is talking about morphemes, and today we are going to know what meant by morpheme and morphemes. Okay. So first of all, we have to know what's morpheme. A morpheme is a short segment of language that meets three criteria. So morpheme is the short segment, is the smallest unit in morphology. It's the basic one. For example, when we are talking about phonetics and phonology, we will say that phoneme is the basic, or the short segment, the short element of phonetics and phonology. But in morphology, in a grammar, we are going to say that morpheme is the short segment of language. It is the short element in morphology. We have here three criteria of morpheme. The first one is that it is a short, it's a word or part of word that has meaning. Okay, so what's meant by this point? Actually, this point is talking about the meaning of the morpheme. We cannot say that this is a morpheme unless it has the meaning. So if we have group of letters together and there is no meaning, we will say it's not morpheme. So morpheme, it has the meaning. Okay, the second one, it cannot be divided into similar meaningful parts. What do we mean by this? The morpheme, we can't divide morpheme to a small part. It means that if we divide morpheme, the meaning will change. We will find no meaning. For example, I have a play, and if I delete the letter Y or the letter L, the meaning will change. Maybe there will be no meaning. So morpheme is cannot be divided into similar meaningful parts. And if we can divide, or can we delete the part of word or part of morpheme, we have two choices. Maybe there is no meaning, and maybe we will find another meaning, exactly another meaning. This is point two. We have the third one. It is a recourse endeavoring variable environment with relatively suitable meaning. What do we mean by this point? It means that morpheme we can find morpheme in some part of any word according to the system or according to the topic that we are talking about. So we can add ed for the past, we can add ing for continuous and something like that. So this is morpheme, and we have three criteria for morpheme. Okay, now there is very important point you have to know. Morpheme, any word that do not have addition, an addition. This is what we know. It is a morpheme. So morpheme, what do we know? Morpheme, a symbol, an unmorpheme in English, just only one morpheme. We have no affixes, suffixes. We have play. Play here is one morpheme. Why? Because we don't have another addition for the word. Okay, we have replay. Here we have two morphemes. We have the first exercise in chapter 8. Exercise 8 to chapter 8 to 1. It means the first exercise in chapter 8. We have here number two, replay. So what's a replay? It means to re again, to play again something. So as long as I have RE, it means that it means that it is two morphemes because we have re and we have play. So these are two morphemes. Okay. We have date. It's just only one morpheme. We have antedate. It means before date. We have two morphemes and something and exactly. We have week one morpheme, weekend two morphemes, and you can find the answer at the end of this book. I think it's very easy. And any question I have, if you have any question, you can ask me, and I'm going to answer you. Okay, we have exercise 2 here. Write the meaning of the morphemes. It means there is underline. For example, we have an underline word, part of word, and maybe a teacher or an English. In general, we will have to know what the meaning of the morpheme. So we have antedate. That means before date. So the answer anti, it means before. Replay, re, it means again. So just you have to memorize these, the meaning of these morphemes, an additional morpheme. This is all about morpheme and the meaning of morpheme. And actually there are some papers that you can find the most of morpheme and and their meaning, the meaning of most of morphemes in English. You can find these maybe on my Telegram channel. Just go to the link and you will find the paper. There are many morphemes with their meaning. Okay, we have for example impossible. Impossible, it means not something that not possible. Inactive, it means not. In means not. Okay, so now we have free and bound morphemes. Here we are going to talk about the types of morphemes in English. We have a free morpheme and we have bound morpheme. Okay, let's know what's meant by free morpheme. Actually, free morpheme means the one that can be uttered alone with meaning. This is the definition of the morpheme. If you would like to memorize, it's very important, and you need it if you want to study for master degree, MA degree, and something like that. So again, what do you mean by free morpheme? It is the morpheme that can be uttered alone with meaning. This is what do we call a free morpheme? It's unmorpheme. It's a morpheme. Sorry, it's a morpheme that has the principal meaning. It's the basic. It's the basic part. The basic part of the word. For example, if I have playing or played, I have play, it's a free morpheme. So why it's a free morpheme? Of course, because it has the principal meaning. And another very important, and there is also a very very important point, we have actually another point you have to put it in your mind. The free morpheme, it's a word or a part of word that can I use in English in a sentence. So it has the principal meaning, it has the main meaning in English. This is what do we call by free morpheme. This is what do we call by free morpheme. Okay. And we have given you an examples. Again, I will give you other examples for that. I have, for example, let's say useful. I have use, and I have full. So use has the principal meaning, and full is an addition morpheme, so it's not free morpheme. Okay, now let's move to another type of morpheme. It is bound morpheme. This is the definition of the bound morpheme. It's unlike free, it cannot be uttered alone with meaning. It is always next to one or more morphemes to form a word. What do we mean by that? This is actually, it's the definition of the morpheme. What do we know about bound morpheme? How can I understand, or how can I Now that this part of word is bound morpheme, actually the bound morpheme cannot be uttered alone with meaning. It means I can't use this type of bound morpheme in a sentence. It is unlike the free morpheme, as I have already said. It is, for example, played. I can play football. So when I say play, I use this type of morpheme in a sentence. It has the principal meaning. So this is a free. But in bound morpheme, actually, we can't use these types of morpheme in English as the main as a main word, as a principal meaning, as a word in a sentence. So for example, I can't say it's you un or ly for example, this type anti. So these types of morphemes needs another part of word to be in full meaning. So when I say played, I have a play, it's a free. And I have ed, it's bound. And maybe there is a question. We'll say, maybe another one teacher will ask me a question. We'll say that, why do we consider play as a free and ed as a bound? We will say that because play has the principal meaning and ed does not have the principal meaning. This is the types of, this is the free morpheme and the bound of morphemes. We have exercise 3 in chapter 8. We have a speaker, speak is a free because it has the principal meaning, and we have er, a bound morpheme. Why? Because why it's bound morpheme? Because it doesn't have the principal meaning. And kingdom, we have kingdom. We have a king, it has the principal meaning, and we have dom, it's not the principal, it doesn't have the principal meaning. So I will say king, dom, free bound morpheme. Sorry. And we have another examples. Also, you can find these, the answers of this exercise at the end of the book. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you understand me well. And please, if you have any question, you can answer. You can ask the questions, and I'm going to answer you soon. Thank you very much, and see you soon.